Hello, this is Dave from Retired Time Productions, and this is a Magix tutorial about the Magix Eye icon. Please don't forget to subscribe because there's going to be a lot more content and you don't want to miss any of it. And make sure you hit the bell icon and a notify checkbox and you won't miss a thing.
I'm Dave, and there's Tom.
Welcome to Retired Time Productions.
We're talking about the hidden eye of Magix Movie Edit Pro. What does it do and where is it? Well, what it does is it actually adds effects curves to various effects and gives you more control over those effects. Now let's take a look at where it is. To find the hidden eye, we need to be using an effect and to be using keyframes. So let's just choose this clip down here. This was provided by a friend of mine, Barney. And we're going to go ahead and add speed to this clip and change the speed as it plays. So let's go ahead and go to the Effects tab, and then we'll scroll down till we find Speed right here. Right now we just have in this keyframes area image size and position. We don't have speed there yet. So let's go ahead and add a keyframe for speed. And the way we do that is we simply click this button right here. And you can see speed, play speed has come up, and there's a keyframe. And there's the Magix Eye right there. That has now appeared. Now if we click that, you'll see a line appear right across here. And that's your effects curve line. So that's how we get to the eye and get the curve to appear. And you can turn the curve on and off just by clicking the eye so it disappears and you can't see it anymore. Keep in mind you can have multiple curves for multiple effects. So you might have several eyes up here. All right, to make keyframes now, all we have to do is click on this line. You get an arrow when you do that, and you just click the line. See how it has a hand, then an arrow? When you get the arrow, click, and it'll put a node right here and a keyframe up here. And that's basically how it works. So say we wanted to ramp up the speed. We'll come along normally like this, and then we want to ramp up the speed, so we would put a node here and the keyframe goes in, and then we'd ramp up the speed right here, so I'll put another node, so then it'll be going full speed. It'll come across here till we get right there, and I've already got a node there. We can drag that node, like put it over here like that. Okay. So now let's ramp it up. So we can go ahead and bring this node up. That ramps the speed up to right there. And you'll notice as we do this that it changes the length of the video. That's because the speed is changing. Okay, so let's just go ahead and put that one there. In fact, let's just make another node because we need to ramp back down, right? So make another node here and then bring this up. Okay, so then we have fast speed across here and then it'll slow down. So if I go ahead and play it, you'll see it comes along normally, speeds up, moves around really quickly, and then slows back down. If we look right in here, say between here and here, we'll see we have a speed of 2. Now we could bring that up to 4 on that keyframe. Just click that keyframe, bring it up to 4. Just drag it over like this and get 4, and then let's click this end node, which is this one right here, get on that other keyframe, okay, right here, that's where we want to be, the other keyframe, bring that up to 4. Now from this node to this node is 4, and down here is going to be more like 1. If we choose, like say here, that's 1, that one's a little slower than 1, let's bring that up to 1 like that. So you see it's easy to put nodes in and then change the speed. You can make it ramp up and down like that. So it comes along slow, normal, speeds up, does a fast turnaround, and then slows back down. Now another thing we can do is go ahead and speed up this middle section even more, and we can do that by coming in here and just making a little cut. And then make a little cut over here. And this will give us more of a hyperspeed ramp. Let's go ahead and move this object out of the way a little bit. And we'll take this stretch tool right here and just narrow that down quite a bit. And then move this back into place. Now we're going to get sort of a hyperspeed effect where it comes across like this, whips around to the next section. So that's the idea with speed, but this can be done with other effects as well. Now, as I said, the Magix Eye will work on other effects as well. So say we wanted to add a curve to some audio. Here's some audio right here, Forever Believe from Audionautics. And what I'm going to do is take this, and you can see the video is down below here, so that's still available right underneath it right there. So I'm going to add some audio. So what we want to do to get the effects curve is we want to scroll down to audio down here. We get to audio, click on general, make sure the audio track is highlighted. Now all we got to do is just change the volume. We can put the cursor where we want it and just change the volume a little bit. And when we do that, you see that pops up right there. We now have a volume entry into our table for keyframes, and we can go ahead and just click a keyframe. And once we click a keyframe, we now have the eye right here. We can now click the eye, and we have our line, and we can now affect the volume. So say we want to put a node right here, and we can bring that down, and then we could bring the volume back up where we need it. Let's do two nodes here, so up, and then maybe we have a little crescendo there and we bring it down. So you can see how we can affect the curves right there. You can change the color of the curve as well to any color you want, and just to make this line show up a little better. Now keep in mind on the audio curves that if you have audio that's combined with a video, you can't get the curve. So the first thing you have to do is separate the audio out by clicking this ungroup icon right here. Now, once the audio comes out, then you can go ahead and apply the curve. And with audio, there's something that none of the other effects seem to have, and that's under this mode right here. If you right click under this icon, there's a curve mode right here. And if you do that, you can then get a curve automatically and put in nodes, which is sort of a shortcut. So I just thought I'd let you know that. But it doesn't seem to work with other things like video levels and stuff. So we'll get into how to do that in a minute. So if you want more information on the audio curves, I have a video tutorial called Audio Volume Curves, and I'll put a link to that in the description under this video. Now, to get the Magix Eye for video level, it's even a little more convoluted. So what we have to do is, I have two video tracks right here. I'm going to click on this one, and if I want to get the curve view on that, what I basically have to do is go into chroma key. So this is really strange, but this is the way I do it. I don't think there's a shortcut key. So what you have to do is you go into video effects again, effects, video effects, and you might have to do this drop down arrow here to get all of the effects. And if you're in the large icon view, you can always just click on this up here and check list view so you can see smaller icons. But anyway, you get down to where chroma key is right here, and within chroma key there is video level right there. And what you do is you just go ahead and change the video level a little bit, and lo and behold, the video level entry pops up in the keyframes area. Okay, now let's just make a keyframe. Now that we have a keyframe, the eye pops up. Then you can click on the eye and you get your line down here. You can see it come and go right there. There it is right there. Once you get the line, you can put nodes in and change the video level like that. So say we want this video to disappear for a while. We could do that, and then we could bring it back up, to full level again, so it would come and go. And then we could go to this bottom one, do the same thing. Just change the level a little bit, hit the keyframe button, turn on the eye, and now we can affect that, put nodes in. So say we wanted this to go kind of the opposite. We wanted it to come in low and then go high, and then we could have it come back out at the same time the other one's coming in, like that. So now when we play it, you'll see one fades in. So it's similar to a crossfade, but you have much more control and you can do multiple fades and crossovers in the middle of the video, whereas normally you just do it at the ends for a crossfade. A crossfade is like when you take two clips and just overlap them. Now you have a crossfade right here. And that's very similar, but you only have a little bit of control by just overlapping videos or using the fades feature within Magix. With this video level, the curve can let you do it anywhere you want. So I have a tutorial on video level curves that's more in depth, and I'll put a link to that in the description under this video as well. Okay, so now let's take a look at one more, and you can use this with color too. So almost any effect you can use it. Say you wanted to do something with color here, maybe affect the saturation. So let's pick on this clip. I've highlighted it. You can see there's nothing here as far as keyframes. Let's kick a keyframe in there like that. And so we start out normal. Now let's turn on the eye. We got our curve. Let me magnify this a little bit. So I've magnified it. That's just using this plus key down here. Okay, now let's put in some nodes just like we did before. And I'll put a node, say, here, another one here. I'll bring the saturation up, and then I can do it again and bring the saturation back down. Now let's try something with color. Let's go back to the beginning. We'll move this a little bit. Now we get another line and we have color level, color angle. Let's say we pick on color level. We'll knock in a keyframe. Let's turn on the eye on color level. There, now I can see it. Now let's hit this and bring the node up. Oh yeah, you can see how that kind of turns green there. All right, so let's make a node right here. And so we'll go to green. And then we'll bring it back down. Put another node. Bring it back down. So now it'll look like this. Sat and color level. So as it gets closer, gets really bright and then fades back away. So you can make a nice effect with that. So just about any of these different effects, you can get the eye and put in a curve. Some of them are not as useful as others, but just keep in mind it's there so you can use it. Now one more hint. If you don't see any of this, if this window isn't there, chances are some of your windows are collapsed. So just go into Window and Window Arrangement, Reset Window Arrangement, and that'll get your keyframe window back so that you can use it. Okay, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe so you can get more content, and stay with me on this because there's a lot more to learn. We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.